It is well known that both children and adults have great difficulties in reading music and playing some musical instruments, such as the piano. Traditionally, this has been attributed to the intrinsic difficulty of the music itself and/or the instrument. However, as we shall see in this paper, the main difficulty is due to the rational design of the standard five-life staff and the piano keyboard. On one hand, with the five-line staff, one has to translate equal geometric distances between note symbols into unequal and irregular musical distances in very different manners, depending on the clef and or the alterations. There have been many criticisms to the five-line staff in the past. For example, in his Confessions, Jean-Jacques Rousseau describes how he approached the composer Rameau, who was apparently top dog in Paris at the time, with his idea for a number-based system of music notation, as opposed to the staff. Rameau was lukewarm on it, and Rousseau took great offense at this, as he did at everything, poor fellow. However, Rousseau was earning some money as a music copyist when he came out with his idea. On the other hand, the designs of musical instruments are not optimal. One typical example is the guitar, seen as 1997. There have been numerous initiatives to introduce a new standard rationalized tuning for guitar. Of course, the current standard tuning is bottom to top, E-A-D-G-B-E. The most popular rationalized version is E-A-D-G-C-F, raising the top two strings a one half step so as to have fourths consistently all the way across. The current tuning, which is learned almost universally by guitar students on any variety, seems to date about from the beginning of the 19th century. A current article in Acoustic Guitar Magazine, A97, states that guitars built before the early 80s had 10 strings, 5 double chords, and were almost identical in form and construction to guitars built many years earlier. The guitar's form started to change at the mid-end of the 18th century and the beginning of the 19th century, when luthiers began undertaking intensive research and experimentation, which ultimately gave birth to the modern guitar. French and Italian luthiers were the first to produce guitars with 6 strings tuned E-A-D-G-B-E. This tuning leads to problems analogous to those to be discussed in this paper for the standard piano keyboard, and the all-fourths tuning provides similar solutions. Example, sight reading and improvisation become much easier, since the relationship between a sound and its corresponding fingerboard shape is simpler to grasp. It is not beyond the realm of imagination that some guitar players might one day adopt such a tunings, although the retooling would be just as substantial as in the piano case, particularly since it is easy to retune a guitar. Many players use several alternative but non-rational tunings in addition to the standard one. The piano is a second example. Due to the standard piano keyboard design, with 7 white keys and 5 black keys, 12 different fingerings are needed for the existing 12 tonalities, and a large number of different chords fingerings have to be used. As we saw in this paper, alternative piano keyboards exist, which lead to a single fingering for all tonalities and to a much smaller number of chord fingerings. When reading and/or playing music, the human brain is subjected to a high pressure to perform such a difficult transformation of fingerings. This causes people to refuse or hate studying or playing music. Figure 1 shows a diagram illustrating the process followed by the player to move from the written musical piece to the instrument. First, the player has to read and understand the piece. This implies a transformation, transformation 1 in the figure, to translate the graphical symbols in the staff to his/her brain. Next, another transformation, transformation 2 in the figure, is required to translate this to the instrument. The above mentioned difficulties experienced by children and adults alike are related to the complexity of the required two transformations. Any effort to simplify this process could directly affect the people's attitudes towards music. A visual analog of musical sound or a set of visual instructions for performance is called a notation. The notation has to meet several tasks. Pitch, the pitch is the degree of highness or lowness and measures the quality of the sound. Or the location of musical sounds on the scale, duration, timbre, or tone, color and volume. There are several types of notation. However, no notation is able to fulfill all these requirements in a total satisfactory manner. In this paper, we deal with graphical pitch representation. The most common way of representing musical sounds is by means of the staff. The staff is a set of parallel lines on or between which notes are placed to indicate their pitch. Staff notation, as it has been developed, is essentially a graph in which the vertical axis represents the pitch, whereas the horizontal axis represents time. Pitch is absolutely fixed by supplying a further indication, the clef, which assigns a definite pitch to a given line or the staff. The staff or Western notation system of music is thought to have been developed by Guido d'Arezzo about the year 1000. He used three or four lines of different colors. A four-line staff was used for plain chant in the 12th century. Hitzbold's De Harmonica Institutione contains an example of six-line staff bearing syllables of chant text, which with the spaces designated tone or semitone. In some countries, keyboard music used six or seven-line staffs until the mid-17th century. The presently customary five-line staff has been used since 1200. In polyphonic music, music written for several voices, and became a standard by the 14th century, remaining unaltered until nowadays. However, as stated in the Encyclopedia Britannica, it was acknowledged international acceptance only in the 20th century, not because an innate superiority, but due to colonization, missionary activity, and ethnological research. In spite of its widespread acceptance, the adequacy of the five-line staff to represent music is yet to be demonstrated. The same is true for the piano keyboard. Of interest are the answers to questions such as: Question 1. Is the five-line staff adequate, or are there other more reasonable alternatives? Question 2. Is the piano keyboard well designed, or are there other more convenient alternatives? In this paper, we answer this and other related questions and show that the classical design of both the five-line staff and the piano keyboard have alternatives that are clearly more advantageous. The rest of the paper is organized as follows. Section 2 gives some elementary but necessary musical background. Sections 3 and 4 discuss the difficulties associated with the five-line staff and the piano keyboard, respectively. In these two sections, we also answer the above questions and provide alternate designs for both the line staff and the piano keyboard. Section 5 discusses how to combine the proposed hexagram and the piano keyboard. A summary and concluding remarks are given in section 6. Some elementary musical background. Natural notes are represented by the first seven letters of the alphabet, A, B, C, D, E, F, and G, or alternatively with the names Do, Re, Mi, Fa, Sol, La, Si. In this paper we deal with the tempered instruments. In well-tempered instruments there are 12 distinct notes in an octave. This build the chromatic scale starting from C, where the symbol sharp is a sharp alteration, which means adding a half tone to the indicated note. There is another alteration, the flat alteration, which means subtracting a half tone to the indicated note. In fact, the use of these two alterations is redundant and can cause some confusion. The musical distances between adjacent notes in one is constant and equal to a half tone. This gives 12 notes per octave and several octaves. Thus, a representation system must be able to clearly and efficiently reproduce all notes corresponding to all octaves. There are 12 different tonalities, which correspond to 12 different manners of interpreting the same musical piece. Assume, for example, that we have several octaves arranged in lines as indicated in 1, and that we have a musical piece, see figure 2, which is represented by the sequence of notes 1, 4, 6, 2, 5, 3. Here, we do not care about durations. If we apply a translation to this piece by adding n units, for example, n equal to 6, we obtain the sequence of notes 7, 10, 12, 8, 11, 9, which sounds exactly the same relatively, but 6 half tones higher than the previous sequence. Thus, changing the tonality is equivalent to adding a fixed number of half tones to every note in a pitch. The simplicity of this formula for changing tonalities is due to the linear representation in one, a possible candidate to a musical representation system. This simple representation system of notes has an important property. Equal geometric distances correspond to equal musical distances. Unfortunately, the five-line staff does not satisfy this common sense property. The five-line staff. In figure 3, we show several notes in the five-line staff. As it is well known, it uses lines and spaces to represent the notes. In addition, several clefs and alterations, as those shown in figure 4, which are symbols placed at the beginning of the I staff to show the pitch of the notes, must be added to the system. There are clear drawbacks in this system. 1. A given symbol in a given location, line or space can have many different meanings, depending on the clef and the alterations. 2. The same note in different octaves is sometimes represented on a line and sometimes on a space. See, for example, the note Do in figure 3. 3. Geometric distances between notes do not correspond to their associated musical distances. In other words, equal geometric distances do not correspond to equal musical distances. This implies A. The musical distance between adjacent lines is not fixed. It ranges from 1 to 6 half tones, considering double alterations. The musical distance between adjacent spaces is not fixed. It ranges from 1 to 6 half tones. The musical distance between a line and its adjacent space ranges from 1 to 4 half tones. As a consequence, what you see is not what you sing. This incredible lack of common sense in the five-line staff leads to serious drawbacks, and the human brain has to make a great effort to translate the written musical piece in the piece to the P read. Note that one needs to. 1. Learn reading notes on lines or spaces between lines in different forms. 2. Translate geometric distances in musical distances using complex transformations. Thus, some convenient properties to be satisfied by a reasonable staff could be: 1. Each note, unit having a given sound, must have a unique representation. 2. Musical distances must correspond to geometric distances. What you see is what you see. Because the unsatisfactory properties associated with the standard five-line staff, in this paper we present as an alternative the hexagram, axis line staff. Why using the number 5, which is not a divisor of 12, the number of half tones in an octave? Clearly, the 6 divisor of 12 is more adequate. So the hexagram is based on see figure 5.1. The notes are represented in lines or spaces, but each note is always represented in the same position, line or space, no matter its octaves. The musical distance corresponding to adjacent lines or spaces is constant and equal to 2 half tones. 3. To cover several octaves, additional lines can be added above or below the hexagram, as it is usually done with the five-line staff. However, notes corresponding to different octaves can also be represented with a number added to it indicating its octave, only when there is a discontinuity with respect to the adjacent notes. The above described hexagram has one degree of freedom, since it remains to define where to represent each note. It is sufficient to fix one note, for example, the C note. It can be represented either on a line or on I space. We leave this decision to more competent people than us to make. The piano keyboard. The piano keyboard consists of a set of levers, keys, actuating its mechanism to produce sound. The actual piano arrangement of keys, keyboard, in 2 rows, see figure 6a, the sharps and flats being grouped by 2 and 3 in the upper black row and the natural notes in the lower white row, exists since early the 15th century. This shows the primacy of the C major scale, which is played on the white key. In this section, we discuss the convenience of the piano keyboard. Some of the drawbacks of the actual piano keyboards are: 1. Due to the system of 7 white keys and 5 black keys, the keyboard is irregular, but periodical, with period equal to 12 keys, 12 half tones. As we shall see, this high value, the highest possible, causes a lot of problems with fingerings and chords. 2. Translation or changing tonality requires a completely different fingering, way of using fingers to play the same musical piece. In fact, for the 12 different tonalities, there are 12 different ways of playing the same musical piece, fingering. Note the 12 different ways of playing the scales. 3. Chords, which are combination of 3 or more notes sounded together in harmony, are very complicated. The major, minor, diminished, etc. chords correspond to completely different positions of the fingers for different notes, even though relative musical distances are the same. This required to memorize 84 or more different chords. Figure 7 shows the 12 seventh chords and their corresponding finger positions. Note that there are no other coincidences apart from the coincidence of EB7 and AB7 and E7 and D7 in finger positions, but not in the keyboard pattern. The inconveniences of the piano keyboard has been of concern in the past by several musicians and piano designers and has led to the appearance of several experimental keyboards. For instance, the sequential keyboard by William Lum under the name of Arthur Walbridge in 1843 aimed at reducing the supremacy of the C major scale. Each octave included 6 lower keys for C sharp, D sharp, F, G, A, and B, and 6 raised ones for C, D, E, F sharp, G sharp, and A sharp. Paul von Hanco keyboard, 1887, is a later application of the same idea. The 2 rows of keys were triplicated, providing a total of 6 rows, each slightly higher than the other, and each including 6 keys in the octave. This arrangement permitted the same fingering in all tonalities. In this paper, we defend an alternative piano keyboard consisting of 6 white keys and 6 black keys, see figure 6b, as proposed by William Long, with a further improvement. In addition, we can add some mobile marks to the beginning of the octave. The associated advantages of this keyboard when compared with the standard keyboard are 1. Due to the system of 6 white keys and 6 black keys, the keyboard is regular and periodical of period equal to 2 keys to half tone. A very low value will facilitate fingerings and chords. 2. Translation of changing tonality requires either no or a very simple fingering change. In fact, for the 12 different tonalities, there are only 2 different and very similar fingerings. Note that now we have only 2 different ways of playing the scale. 3. Chords are very simple. The major, minor, diminished, etc. chords are played with the same or a simple change of in fingers positions for different notes. This requires to memorize only 14 different chords instead of 84. Figure 8 shows the 12 seventh chords and their corresponding finger positions. Note that we have only 2 different finger positions for the 12 chords. 4th, the length required for each octave is shorter, because black keys are shorter than white keys. In fact, we save 1/7, this facilitates fingering. An extra advantage can be obtained by designing double-shaped keys, as illustrated in figure 9, where the odd keys are light gray shadow and the even keys are dotted. Since the keys are double-shaped keys, passing in the same number zone means passing the same keys and thus producing the same sound. With this keyboard design we have 1. The same fingering for all tonalities. We need only using either the lower or the upper keyboards. 2. 2 options for fingering depending on which part of the keyboard we play, upper or lower. 3. Chord fingerings are reduced to 7 instead of 14. Combining the hexagram and the piano. The hexagram can be combined with the new piano keyboard just to lead to what you see is what you play. The idea consists of using a vertical arrangement of the notes in order to get a direct representation, see figure 10, where lines correspond to black keys, upper level keys, and spaces between lines to white keys. Figure 11 shows an example of a musical piece using the usually horizontal arrangement and its corresponding vertical arrangement. Both can be interpreted as an indication of the sequence of keys to be played, but the second is easier to use, in the case of the piano, because no transformation from vertical to horizontal displacement is required. Summary and concluding remarks. We have discussed the drawbacks of the 5-line staff and the standard piano keyboard for representing and playing music respectively. The fact that identical geometric distances in both do not correspond to identical musical distances measured in terms of half tones causes a lot of confusion and makes the arts of reading and playing music more difficult. Alternative solutions have been presented and discussed. We saw clear advantages of the classical solution. A serious thought about the problem is suggested in order to attract more people to the beautiful and incredible world of music. Acknowledgements. The author is grateful to Esteban Sanz Vélez, Ali Hadi, and John Bunge for their valuable comments and suggestions. He also thanks Mariano Hernando for providing the beautiful images.